Let's first look at the extended version of the IV infusion calculations. As I mentioned, you can choose either whilst you're practicing and for your exam. So we get given our information as usual at the top here, and when we read our instructions, the first thing we are being asked to do here is to calculate mils per hour. Because we know that's what we're trying to calculate, we can add that into our equation to begin with. We know that our answer needs to be in mils per hour. That means mils divided by hours. So here, we know that the information on the top is going to have to be mils, and the information on the bottom is going to be hours. Mils per hour, and mils per hour here. So our equation balances. We then need to look back to the top to see which bit of information relates to the mils and which bit relates to the hours. So our volume is 50 and our duration is 1 hour. The calculation then becomes 50 mils divided by 1 hour. 50 divided by 1 is just 50, and mils per hour. We hit next. This section tells us that we need to set the volumetric pump. Again, read the instructions. You're asked to input the rate in mils per hour at the top. Click rate, type in your 50 from your answer. And the next bit of information they need is the volume in mils. Again, the information in mils is 50. And we click run. This next section is asking you to calculate as if you were setting up manually. Therefore, we are trying to calculate drops per minute. We know that our answer needs to be in drops per minute, so we can add that in straight away. The first bit of our information for the equation is exactly the same as step one. The volume, which was 50 mils, and the hour, which was 1. Now, to be able to get from mils to drops and from hours to minutes, we need to do some converting. To be able to get from mils to drops, we need to know how many drops are in every mil. It tells us that information up here under the IV administration set. Therefore, the bit of information that goes in this box is 15 drops per mil. And to get from hours to minutes, we do the same thing every time for every answer and every question on Safe Medicate when we're using the extended version. And that is that there are 60 minutes in every hour. That piece of information you need to know, it is not written up here at the top. There are multiple ways of being able to calculate this, whether you do 50 divided by 1 and then 15 divided by 60 separately, or personally, the way I like to do it is across this direction. Having a scrap piece of paper will be very handy. So our 50 times our 15, remember, you'll be allowed to use a calculator for this, gives us 750. On the bottom, our 1 times our 60 will just be 60. So now we are doing 750 divided by 60. The answer to that is 12.5. But remember that you can't get half a drop or part of a drop whenever you're calculating it going through an administration set. So the instruction here is that you round to the nearest whole number. That means if it is 0.5 or above, you round up. If it's 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 or 0.4, you round down. In this case, 12.5 would be rounded up to 13. We click next, and we get to do it. So we move to calculate our 13 drops per minute. Hitting next should show us that we got the correct answer. In the next video, I'll talk you through how to use the drop rate denominator method.